For some time, transitioning between scenes was not a strong suit of OBS Studio. But in recent updates, they have added a wide variety of transition options, and now the ability to import your own custom video transitions. This is an extremely powerful feature, though it could use some improvements. Let's take a look right after this. I'm Meeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have, in case you haven't noticed, a lot of videos on this linked in the playlist in the video description. Go check them out if you have any questions. I should hopefully have answered all of them. And check the intro video to see how this whole course works in case you get confused. To use transitions, you need to select one in the Scenes Transition menu module and click the dropdown. Here, you can choose a transition type to be active. Below this, you can change the duration of the transition period in milliseconds. The default was 300 milliseconds for me, which is 1/3 of a second. In between those two boxes are buttons to add a new transition, something we'll be using a lot, remove a transition from the list, and a settings cog to change transition settings. As of version 20.0.1 and the production of this course, you can only set up a single transition to be used at a time. This means that whichever option is showing in the drop-down menu when it's not expanded is the transition that will happen when you switch scenes. The same transition carries over if you go into dual view studio mode as well. I would like to see the ability to add per scene transitions so that you can use specific transitions depending on what you're switching to. For example, quick cut transitions between multiple camera angles but lengthier stinger style transitions when going to BRB screens or between a game view and a desktop view. The only way this can currently be done is via the advanced scene switcher plugin that I use for auto scene switching, and even this isn't for normal switching, it's just for auto switching. A video on that plugin is in the course playlist if you're interested in that, I did cover that in depth. If you only see cut, or the original combo of cut, swipe, and slide, fear not. Simply click the big plus and you have the option to add custom transitions from a few new options. Fade to color does as it sounds. Opening up its properties lets you choose a color, though keep in mind if you choose a custom color from the hue board, you will have to hit add to custom colors and choose it from that list before applying. A really weird thing. Otherwise, choose one of the color choices or click pick screen color to get an eyedropper to pick any color visible on the screen. This one automatically adds custom colors and selects it. Hit OK. You can also choose at which point during the transition that the full color should be 100% present and opaque. Typically, you want to leave this at 50%. Hit OK again and now you can fade to your chosen color as a transition. You can add multiple fade to color transitions to switch between via the drop-down menu. As with every transition. Adding a Luma Wipe transition lets you pick from a preset list of transition modes typically used as built-in presets for video editors. This gives you a wide selection of wipes, linear wipes, clock wipes, zigzags, barn doors, and all sorts of them. It pops up this big, empty window for some reason, resize it, and move it so you can switch between scenes in the main OBS window and preview the transitions. Doesn't work in the actual transition menu. The softness number affects how hard or soft the edges of the shapes are. Play with this to your liking. You can also invert the shapes of the transitions to do the reverse. Click OK when you're done. Lastly, we have the stinger. A stinger transition is basically a video clip or animation that fills the screen briefly while scenes transition and then pulls off of the screen. This is key for high quality production value for broadcasts and can even be seen in some cartoons. You can make these yourself using most higher level video editors by rendering them as an MOV or uncompressed AVI with an alpha transparency layer included. You can also find plenty of basic free ones online with a few easy Google searches or get higher quality royalty free ones from a marketplace like Videoblox. I'll include a couple basic ones linked in the video description. I cannot share all the ones that I use since some of them are from Videoblox or directly from creators and so on, but I can share a couple. This used to require a plugin for the program, but they've recently integrated it into the full software, a very powerful feature. You add a stinger transition much like any other transition. Click the plus under Scene Transitions UI module and click Stinger. Give it a name based on what transition you're using. Now browse and find your video file. Again, it needs to be a video with alpha transparency built in. You can't chroma key it or anything like that. And audio isn't currently supported with these transitions either. Ideally, this window would show you a preview and such to help you out here, but it doesn't. You have to move the window out of the way and test scene transitioning on the actual main OBS window. You also need to pop in a number, either in milliseconds or frames, that the transition actually happens at. This needs to be whenever your graphic fully fills the frame so that viewers don't see the actual transition taking place. You can get the exact millisecond or frame time from your video editor, or just play the clip back, find the exact point, and do the math to convert to milliseconds, and you're good to go. With that stinger transition enabled, it will now show up when you switch scenes, and it is pretty neat. And that's it. OBS Studio provides quite the plethora of options for transitions during your live streams or recording. It just takes a little navigation to get them set up for you. And hopefully, before too long, they'll add in the capabilities to assign transitions to specific scenes. Crossing my fingers here. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it has, hit the like button, subscribe for more awesome tech content, come follow me on Twitch if you like game streaming, and drop me a message in chat. Until next time, I'm EvilsVox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/evilsvox to sign up.